We are in Norfolk, but we're off to a house called Vowood. We're about to see a remarkable arts and crafts house. It's one of those places that sort of you think, what on earth? Where, like, it's been dropped from another planet.
Really?
Yeah.
Vowood House is a Grade 2 listed building, built between 1903 and 1905, with Grade 1 listed gardens. Rare book dealer Simon Finch bought the house in 1998 and has restored it to its former glory.
The arts and crafts movement was a return to more traditional methods of construction in a reaction to the Industrial Revolution. When I bought it, it was an old people's home. I kind of just really fell in love with it, and how can you not? I mean, just look at it, it's extraordinary.
This exceptional house has been furnished with an eclectic array of artworks, furniture, and other beautiful items.
I just love buying objects. I'm a rare book dealer, but, you know, inevitably you'd come across stuff. I don't choose what to buy. I mean, I just see it and I just think, I quite like that. Quite impulsive.
Hi.
Hello.
How are you doing?
Hello. Simon, how are you doing? Good to meet you.
Hi, MT. How are you doing?
Hi,
you all right?
Good. Welcome.
Thank you so much. I've read about this place, so it's really good to see it. It's amazing. Can we all go in?
Come in.
After you. Thank you.
So how long did it take to do this? Because it's a remarkable... The house looks stunning. Beautiful.
It took about, you know, 8 years. I mean, I've had an endless... I could have done it quicker.
But... Yeah. This house is astonishing. At every single turn, inside, outside, underneath, it's incredible. And it literally knocks your socks off.
However much Drew loves the house, he's here to do deals.
That's the sort of thing that I buy.
That's
up my street, actually.
Well, I mean, you can probably buy that if you're generous with me.
Yeah, I will be.
You will be?
No.
Yeah. Oh, no, of course, let's be hard about it.
No. It's a nice little Rexine work chair.
Yeah.
Mid to late 50s. That's got the original cover, the original paint, the original markings on the whole thing. It's not bent, it's not been welded, it's not been stripped. It's mint, it's the best one I've ever seen.
This chair was made by Lee Bank. They were manufacturers of office furniture from the 1930s to the 1970s. Chairs like this could have a value of around £450.
What's it going to cost me today? What would you like for it?
Well, what are you going to offer me for it then? Come on, just...
200 quid.
300, it's yours. I'm not doing it for less.
Remember those ones I found over in Battle? Yes. They're more or less the same, weren't they? We sold them for what? £295 each.
Oh, no.
We did.
£250.
Sold. There you go. Simon's been a dealer for a very long time. His negotiating skills are very strong. He's sort of, no, £300 and not a penny less. It's that. Bang, yes or no. I can use that to my advantage as well.
The house features work by contemporary artists and friends too.
He's been very brave by getting artists in and giving them completely free rein to do whatever they want. Now that again harks back to the arts and crafts movement.
But Drew's not looking for artworks today.
Cellar.
Cool, cellar.
So what have we got here? Ah, is this what you wanted to show
us?
Yeah,
I think there are about 9 of them.
I've got a hell of a lot of these. Like a lot, you know. But I stripped the hospital full of them out. And every bed had one.
They're going to be livid when they find out.
Once restored, these angle-poised factory lights could be worth around £200 each.
It's all down to price, really.
Yeah,
what do you want each for them? And then I'd buy them all if the price was right, you know, but I'm not mad keen to own them.
£350 the lot.
How much is that each? Sounds about right. Sold.
Letting Simon price items first gives Drew an advantage.
What I'm going to do now is I'm going to start asking the prices to Simon, and he comes up with £350 for the 9. Bites hand off. Done. I'll have those. That's good business.
Away from the period house, Drew's about to make his most remarkable deal.
So this is your haven.
This is where I'm trying to.
Fairly new as well.
Totally new. I'm just moving in. Yeah. You can make me an offer. I mean, I bought this again with a collection of books.
How long have you had this?
I reckon I've had this 15 years.
Okay. Charles and Ray Eames for Herman Miller, 1956.
This lounge chair and matching ottoman were designed by American husband and wife team, Charles and Ray Eames. The design duo were known for groundbreaking contributions to architecture, furniture design, manufacturing, and photography. They wanted this lounge chair to have the warm and receptive look of a well-used baseball mitt.
The guys who buy these chairs, it's about the condition.
Yeah.
And this one's rough.
Rough?
Yeah, look, it's got coach bolts in it.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
The chair became an icon of American design and features in the Museum of Modern Art in New York. This chair could be worth around £3,000.
It's a design classic. It's right up there. It's top three. So to find an unrestored, really early, marked Eames with footstool, happy days.
Sticking with his strategy, Drew asked Simon for his price first.
Right, what would you like for it?
Well, you're the dealer.
You're a dealer too.
I know, but
You're a dealer too.
I'm a dealer in books.
Have you seen your house? You're clearly a way better dealer than I'm ever going to be. So you need to. Come on.
£1,200.
Sold. Thank you.
That was a bit quick.
Yeah, I know. You didn't like that, did you? I'm very pleased with that price.
We're never going to get you out of that, are we?
I'm beginning to regret it already. What can I replace it with?
I've got one for sale.
What? Give me $1,250.